Yeah, let's talk to her.
I've collected everything now. What do I do?
Throw those bad boys into the machine!
Okay. I have to do every single one?
Free limbs for everyone. No, wait, I need these.
Oh, right. The limb depository, Chad, of course.
Mr. Meaton says well done. He won't be passive-aggressively pushing stuff off your table. For your effort, I'm going to give you an honorary membership to Paxt. It includes a free cupcake. They're super delish.
What?
Anyway, I'll go get the machine started. Just press the yellow button.
Give me money. Engage determination face. Activate multiverse method destroying failsafe.
Forum scientists go!
It's Pierce Lou. Activate Pierce.
Yes!
Form fissionable legs.
Yes!
Form arms. Attach below average hit.
Hey! I'm back!
Welcome back.
That was pretty weird.
Oh no, dude!
Oh god, it hurt!
Dude, bro!
Stop!
Go ask him how to defeat Olaf. Quick, just in case he dies.
I don't want to die! Who said anything about dying?
Oh my god, dude! Don't make me look at him! Hold on, I gotta turn off text to speech on the resubs. So I'm gonna click this one real quick.
How do I defeat Le Checker in Primate Isle?
I don't know what that is.
Okay.
How do I defeat the oppressive government?
Well, you place explosives in the underground car parks of the biggest credit card companies. Wait, don't do that.
Chat, did we just find out the secret?
How do I defeat Olaf?
Dude, I literally just came back from the multidimensional plane. I'm all messed up. You don't want to know where my genitals are. It was torture. The guy kept telling me dad jokes. It was the worst. And now you're asking me all these heavy questions, man. Bad vibes.
Hey, I met that guy as well. I feel your pain.
Oh, right. I guess Olaf is a dick anyway.
It's true.
I don't actually know. But I do know where you can get some juicy goss that'll go viral on the net, destroying his public image.
Gossip.
I'll cast the clickbait curse. I'll be some sort of internet wizard.
Could I use the goss to construct some dope rams instead, to defeat him in a rap battle?
That's a pretty good idea, actually. But yes, I think there is a more effective way. Topo Genetics has a space station which they went halfsies on with a local pickled cucumber company. It's actually amazing how much power they hold over Eastern and Western Europe now. Anyway, Topo Genetics holds all their sensitive documents there, including Olaf's genetic file. All you need to do is insert this floppy into the main computer and voice activate it with the password, I don't know what to say, oh shit, is it recording? I'll take it from there.
Please don't tell me I need to use the teleporter again.
Don't worry. It was originally designed for this station so that we could figure out why the operator went out of radio contact. Then, to save some of that cash money. Only downside, really, is the 1000% of your daily radiation intake needs. You should be fine, though. Press the yellow button 3 times and you'll be good to go.
Okay. Did he give me the disc? He did. Let's talk to her first. I need a date.
I've got to go feed my dog.
Okay.
Choking just like in real life, boys.
I'll give you a buzz, dude, once you get there.
Cheers. Laters.
Is it gonna make me watch him push it 3 times? Oh! What?
Bro, Bro.
Teleporting is starting to feel pleasurable. Hold on.
Why have it?
I'm speaking Swedish.
Bro.
Hey, dude, it's me. How you doing, buddy?
Vava Prato Vojka Sprook.
Oh, right. Dupa Genetics was working on a real-time translator. Forgot about that. As well as the clone machine. Pretty cool.
Could this thing go off?
It was actually one of its many problems. You need to turn it off, otherwise you can't say the password correctly.
What?
Well, you probably won't be able to say anything correctly, really. The translations it makes are laughable. And occasionally don't even work. Good luck. Peace!
Janta, who for shit the Viggy Xir?
I spent a lot of time in IKEA.
Hey.
Oh yeah. Swedish meatballs.
They're not even that good, chat. I said it. So we have to turn off the fucking... Let's talk to the cabbage nut.
Cześć. Przestania mnie tak patrzeć, kapuśnie człowieku. Nie zmuszaj mnie do tego, bym że ciebie zrobię głąbki.
Okay. Well, let's turn it off then. Main bigot computer.
Cześć, komputerze bigocie. Dobrze by było, gdybyś się zmienił.
I wish you would change your ways.
Man, you made my week showing the drawing of all my spare bits.
This is a good ass drawing, dude. I don't flirt with bigots. We gotta turn off the translator. Okay, where's the translator, chat? Larry the dog.
Hello, like it's white, sie werden für uns alle eine Inspiration.
Oh. I'm dumb.
Bro. Bro, bro, bro.
Bro. Bro, 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 bro.
Bro.
Clone machine. What?
Thank you for activating the Alpha cloning system. Made to alleviate you of mundane tasks. Clones are only to be used for said mundane tasks. I'm looking at you, Mishlav. We know the sick stuff you're into.
Ew!
Control the clones with the top left interface when it appears. Repeat the word, combust, when you're done with
them. Oh no. What? Oh, I see. I can make four clones. Okay. Oh. No. Okay. What? What is making the I'm trying to light all these up right here, but what is making that go off? Is it just me walking over it? Yeah. It doesn't stay on. It just lights up when I go into that quadrant. Okay. Let's just make a fourth clone. Or third clone. Giant toehead? That's a tumor! This is fucking weird.
Can I speak English now?
We did it!
Oh, yes. I guess I don't need you guys anymore. I feel like I've gotten to know all of you very well.
Oh god, here it comes.
And it pains me that there can only be one real paradigm. Will the real paradigm please stand up? I guess that was a stupid question. Well, I'm terrible with goodbyes. Laters.
Combust.
No! No!
I can finally use the computer now.
I thought they're gonna blow up in like bloody chunks chat. Let's talk to the cabbage knot first.
Chesh. Weird.
Kage Bushin no jutsu.
Ingrained into my brain. I probably should schedule a doctor's appointment once this is all over. Так на правде, то нецего троєму вонспіве. Дуже няня фісних, so weird. It seems I...
Is that like a bug or something that they couldn't figure out how to fix?
I can use the floppy now.
Yay.
I hope the multiverse didn't take my stuff again. Weird, I'm speaking in English again. I guess it's a bug with the translator. I'll send the translator dev some constructive feedback once this is all over.
I don't understand what is happening. Do it!
I don't know what to say. Oh shit, it's recording.
That's the password, chat.
I miss all tech. New computers don't threaten your livelihood with high voltage. It's just not the same, you know? Yo, scientist guy, I've got the info.
Great! Also, another might be some juicy goss on Tuba and yourself up there. So it's cool if you don't want to leave yet. Just press the pickup button when you're ready to leave.
I really want to talk to the cabbage knot, dude.
Alrighty, I'm ready to be torn apart by a journey through space and time.
Oh no! What am I doing? We got the bad end, chat! We didn't look for the goss! I'm so dumb.
Yeah.
I didn't even think.
Here's the floppy with the info on it.
Alright, let me suss this out on the computer.
Fuck, dude. Restart? I don't want to go through all that again.
What's the deal?
Okay, so the basic rundown is... He's a genetically engineered sloth, but they couldn't remove all his natural instincts, which include doing nothing all day and chilling on trees.
Like a stoner?
No. Like a sloth. Anyway, after you're done making shit jokes, if you could get a tree near him, it'd probably ignite his instincts. A 5-meter tree would probably do fine. It is a peer-reviewed scientific journal I published on it.
I have that. We sequence broke the game and we currently have that.
I'm not sure you understand what peer-reviewed means.
You watched me as I drew it. Peer-reviewed.
What the hell? A 5-meter tree?
What other choice do you have? Let's be honest. This place has a bunch of messed up stuff going on. Just look at me. You'll find some solution.
True.
But you'll also need to get inside his room. The door is locked. Only the leader of the church of Leather the Glam goes in there usually. He has a necklace that lets him in. You'll need to get it off him.
Great.
The statue?
He loves to fight for things. Nostalgic about his wrestling days. And he loves JRPGs.
Ew.
I'll put it on a piece of paper too so you can remember.
Okay.
Thank you for betraying your employer at the drop of a hat.
Hey, no worries, man. I am a man of integrity, with a crippling addiction to free-to-play, food-based MMOs, which was probably going to get me fired at a moment's notice. Worth it.
Once you get the stealth paradigm, I should have a plan to take down Olaf ready. So hit us up when you do.
Man, I'm never going to get to finish my EP.
What? Excuse me?
So, you finally decided to open mysterious hatch. Too bad I've already met another hatch. We're doing great. No. No, stop. You're the one I've always wanted.
Your paradigm? By the way...
Yeah?
That's where they keep all the faulty prodigy children. Your brothers and sisters. Kind of.
Oh, God.
You can check it out if you like. Might be super weird and traumatic.
Let's do it.
Whatever. Do what you want. I'm not your mom. I guess that was pretty insensitive since you were grown in a vat. I'm just gonna wish you luck. That's what people do, right?
What did I just get? Oh, the note I had to defeat him. Alright, let's see if we can go back. Pretty sure we can't, though, dude.
Gotta collect them all. Limby Mon doesn't have quite the same ring to it. In other words, I need the scientist limbs before I can use it.
XD. This game's falling apart.
No thanks. I would like to at least on.
Okay, let's go look at our faulty brothers and sisters chat. Hello? Why did it stop? Hello? Oh.
Shit. Goddamn, Geometry Gate is always blocking dank entrances. Most people think they are from Crusher's radiation problem.
It's a crocodile!
But it's just a gross misuse of selective breathing. Just gotta smack him a few times.
Okay. Fuck him up, dude. Oh, God.
Welcome to the live art installation of the Forgotten Prodigy Children. Help yourself to the free wine and nibblies over there.
I will. Thank you.
Not sure I want to eat dungeon food. It's a personal rule I have.
Pussy.
I can't just take the only thing that might actually tempt someone to come to this art exhibition. That would be immoral, but delicious.
Fish, dude. No, don't go away. I'm not done.
Hello, fishman. Are you more of a man or a fish? Maybe you go by manfish instead. Maybe boyfish. Ladyfish? Fishfish. Man-man? I give up.
Good. Let's talk to the keyboard, dude.
I'll make sure to use him as an example where I don't want my music career to go. Okay, look.
Can't you see you're interrupting my visionary performance? Do it again and I will continue to scream!
Wait. I've heard of magic melancholy. His target demographic is heartbroken wizards. Financially, he doesn't do well. Mostly because wizards are known for digital piracy.
Can I use the toilet?
Pretty sure that guy over there winked at me. I'd like to use a toilet where I don't get winked at. Is this too much to ask? Hello?
Bang, bang, bang.
Yes, you are correct. I've always thought I could be a fashion model. I just didn't have the height. A forerunner in tumor fashion. I believe this is a piece commenting on how construction workers are slowly morphing into their tools because of a curse which is cast when they were kicked out of the union. Never take away witches' rights for 5 weeks paid vacation. What is this place?
It's the hottest exhibition in all of Krush.
It looks more like a dank dungeon prison to me.
Yeah, to some regular art pleb like you.
Oh, fuck.
Come on. Look at the mood lighting. Don't lie to me. That's definitely dank dungeon lighting.
All right. It's an art exhibition which happens to be in a dungeon prison where Dupa Genetics keeps all its faulty prodigy children. Just between you and me, I think some very rich art collectors are coming down here soon. People are starting to realize the appeal of dungeon prisoner art.
Mm-hmm.
What did you do before you decided to take up performance art?
I was a prodigy at pen spinning. You know, the one kid who was always good at spinning the pen on his hand. Yeah, I know, pretty lame. The guy who ordered me was super mad that his university friend could do it, but he couldn't. So he commissioned me. Now I can't even look at pens without getting PTSD.
No, dude.
I'm a prodigy child too, you know. An electronic music prodigy, that is. Aiming to become the greatest in the world.
Really? For commercial or deep and meaningful artistic reasons? Do you have rationale? Do you pleasure yourself over the sheer level of artistic intelligence that emanates from your head? I know I do.
I just, like the way some beeps and boops sound, I guess. Also, I would not be opposed to fat steaks.
You truly are a disgusting human being, Paradigm. Art is for the soul and for stroking the ego. You are not an artist.
Now I see why you peeps are in a dungeon. Can I give you a critique?
No, you're wrong.
I didn't say anything.
Wrong!
Can I ask you something else?
Sure, Preferably about me and my art, though.
What is the meaning behind your performance art?
You're supposed to interpret it yourself. Who am I kidding? It's too smart for anyone to guess. Especially a pleb like you. Couldn't work it out in a million years. First, you need to know the context. Alright, so me with this apple on my head represents the vegan industry caught up in its own philosophies. Also, me in general feeling stuck. The skull above my head represents death looming above us. The party hat means that death sometimes can party, like when you party and almost overdose. However, there are a bunch of extra meanings. I mean, that was just the synopsis. Basically, if you look a little bit more closely, there is some dirt here. Mm-hmm. This actually represents how dirty we are. I say we, I mean modern society, i.e. you, with its dirty and hypocritical morals. Damn, I'm on another plane of thinking. And that was the shortened summary.
Wait, what?
Were you even listening?
Yes. Who is your favorite artist?
Krzysztof Kandowski.
Why?
The few people who have seen it still don't understand his art. He makes me so inspired.
Have you considered he might just be mentally insane?
Oh,
and that's why his art is incomprehensible.
Don't make me get my X-Acto blade out. I'll carve my initials on you and claim you as a living, breathing, eating art piece.
My life is already an art piece of self-loathing, sloth, and gluttony. What is true art?
True art is...
What?
I'm sorry. Us true artists have ascended to another method of communication.
Mm-hmm.
One that a peasant like you wouldn't understand.
Okay, see ya. Enjoy your thing.
Bye, pleb.
I'd fucking Nebraska.
Man, that skull likes to live dangerously. On the edge. I totally want to party with that skull.
No partying with the skull!
But you said that it was about partying with death.
Hello, party skull.
Hold on.
Looks like this is the only thing holding it.
Can I kill her?
I need a small flathead screwdriver.
Fortunately, I've got a multi-purpose... Oh, come on, man. Can I use... Nope. My skull has the same head. Phil's birthday, man. Lol.
I feel the asbestos lining my lungs.
It's just like drinking a warm glass of milk.
Do you guys see a screwdriver at all here, by the way?
I read once that piles of rubble in your living space increases happiness by 20%. Or was it asbestos-related cancers?
I get the two mixed up all the time.
Oh, I need this. This is for the tree that we got.
I will murder you if you try to wreck my performance piece.
We have to kill her, dude. Gordork. Occupation, dungeon dweller. I've lived in this dungeon for years, decades, and now these prodigy children think that they can just walk in here and start gentrification willy-nilly. They've driven up dungeon grime corners up by 10,000%. How are my mitosis copies of myself going to afford them in the future? I'm going to write a long and angry letter to the local dungeon council to get this sorted out. All right. That doesn't help. There's probably a screwdriver somewhere else. We need to drop this on her and kill her.
Ok, Okay, look. Portable floodlights are great for when you can't pay your bills and don't want to cry in the dark.
Great.
Hello, portable floodlight. I once changed a man's life using the art of shadow puppetry. That man was me, after another man kicked the shit out of me for having such a lame hobby. Then how will Applehead set the cinematic mood?
Glowing corridor.
It's a big empty room with a dude adjusting a light dimmer switch.
It's not just adjusting the dimmer switch, you art lab.
What is it then?
By adjusting.
Yeah, I don't care.
Hey, wait, god damn it. I knew I should have worn some sort of dumb head.
Did I check the toilet? Yeah.
I prefer to use it on police helicopters. Like, what else do you use a laser pointer for?
I saw a YouTube video of someone getting arrested by the FBI for doing that. Chat, don't ever do that. You'll go to jail. Okay?
I prefer to use
What? Help!
Hello?
Hello, traveler. I don't have any gold coins, if that's what you're going to ask me. I lost that loot a long, long time ago.
To a valiant warrior in search of valor and glory?
No, to a messy divorce, in which I also lost my favorite coffee mug. If you don't mind, I'd rather not talk about it.
Hey man, you sure? Sounds like you need to talk it out.
No. I've cried enough today.
Steve Lichtman.
See you later.
It's... So, wait a minute. You're not just gonna leave, right? Because that would be crazy. I mean, I just told you I have a messy divorce. You know, I don't have a hell of a lot of loot down here. And I mean, look around. I don't have any friends. I listen to ambient dungeon music, and you're just gonna leave me down here? I mean, that sounds crazy to me. That just sounds crazy. I don't think that's right. Is this goodbye, or? Have you decided, based on what I just said, that you might stick around a little longer? Oh, so it is goodbye. Oh, well, in that case, I do feel like killing myself, but I guess...
Whoa!
That's not an option, so...
He's a lich!
Oh, boy. Here's looking forward to the rest of existence, I guess. Hey, good luck on your trip, your journey, whatever it is, you know? I mean... You could try and lift the dungeon's curse and get me out of here. Does that sound good? Does that sound like something you'd be interested in? Having a cool skeleton friend to join you on your RPG-esque adventure? If that's what this is, I don't know what it is. Is that what this is? That's not what this is. So this isn't a team-based adventure you're on. Well, yeah, I mean, I'm just gonna live down here forever then, I guess. Yeah, I mean, have a good trip. It's nice to see a smiling face for once. Goodbye, hideous man.
You're just mashing things together now, aren't you?
What? Fuck you, dude!
What are you doing here?
It's just a little place I like to get away to, you know? Clear my head. Kind of like a holiday home. It's also the only place I can practice my baking and not be called a pussy bitch.
Oh god, I choked on my spit.
What do you do?
I've got a really successful Pinterest page with all sorts of baked goodies and craft tips. But I guess my day job is dungeon lord slash lich king. You know, you gotta make a living. Or a dying. I'm way funnier when I write. Not really an improv guy. You should read my blog. Always get comments with like four ha's. It was a long road from two ha's, but I persevered and got there.
What's that music you are playing?
That's an ambient dungeon track I picked up last week. It's super soothing to listen to. My anxiety acts up when I hear these sounds in real life. Performance anxiety, you know? Not even medication helps. But the recorded version is relaxing. Funny how life works like that.
What's that? Terrible smell.
Oh, you don't like my scented candle? It's called Death and Despair. I can't actually smell it. But the thought of it being there gives me nostalgia for the golden years of dungeon keeping.
If I met you right now, will you drop any loot at all?
The only loot you'll get is knowing you gave me sweet release from my painful existence.
Oh, right. How about that lever, hey? See you, Lich King.
It's Steve. So, wait a minute.
Knife spoon.
You're not just gonna leave, right? Because that would be crazy. I mean, I just told you I have a messy divorce. You know, I don't have a hell of a lot of loot down here. I mean, look around. I don't have any friends. I listen to ambient dungeon music. And
not again.
And you're just going to leave me down here? I mean, that sounds crazy to me. That just sounds crazy. I don't think that's right. I used the last of... It's paid... Oh, well, in that case,
what?
You've got thing. I use the last of my money the rest of existence, I guess. Having a cool skeleton. So this isn't a team. Goodbye, hideous. Thanks. I use the last of my money on it after the divorce. It's paid for itself tenfold with all the money I make from bake sales. Not to mention improving my mental health.
We speed ran the fucking dialogue chat. We found a bug because he talks to us when we activate this.
Hello, I tried, man.
Pog champ. I don't think there's anything we can do here, Charon. I think we're good. Chat, I can't interact with the... give him the number. Alright, fine.
I know she didn't want me to have it, but she might change her mind. Gotta delete Mutant Facebook and hit the gym.
Nope.
I've...
Chat, you're all wrong. Chat, I can't interact with the chest! Everyone shut up, okay? Alright, everyone shut up. Okay. Let's go look in the church for a screwdriver or something. Give him the mug I tried already, dude. What? You just want to save him? Me too, chat. I did. Gremlin under the tea? Nope. I hovered my mouse over that. To the church! Screwdriver's next to cloning machine. You almost got me, dude, motherfucker. We need that necklace up there, chat. Whoa. He's coming.
Here. What's supposed to wake
Oh shit! Here's the throw. Defeating Cactus Slinky Man. Was that what was being shot into his mouth? Anyway, this is where the Metal Messiah was injected into a pug's body by the Gnat of Olaf, who only wants to bring about glam metal and professional wrestling magic to the world as the only form of entertainment. That's their evil plan. And this guy is integral, so let's talk to him.
Welcome, my son, to the Church of Latter-day Glam. May your hair be fabulous, your pants be tight, and your excess be excessive. What is it you ask of me?
Your hair is glorious. Can I touch it?
Are you a groupie?
I can be.
I don't think so, dude.
So close to achieving pure bliss. Aw, look at those cute little boots.
I know you're trying to be demeaning, but yes, they are cute little boots. Comfortable, too.
Oh my god.
How did you become the messiah of a glam metal cult?
Well, I was one of the world's most famous wrestlers a while back. My shtick was that I was a singer from a glam metal band. My fame led to a life of excess, naturally. I did a lot of drugs and acquired new diseases that people didn't even know existed. I got to name a few. It was pretty cool. Anyway, long story short, I obliterated my body, and here comes this duper genetics guy, and he offers me a new one if I run his glam metal cult. Cool. Heard you get more chicks if you're a cult leader. What he failed to tell me is they don't yet have the tech to grow me a new body, so they put me in a pug temporarily.
Brutal.
Honestly, now I'm considering going half pug, half human for my final form.
What is it like being a pug?
Pretty good. Get apes of belly rubs. Can finally lick my own balls. Downside is that I need to chase things. Cats, tennis balls, all the stereotypical stuff.
What about chasing hoop dreams?
What is this, a 90s basketball movie?
To be honest, I won't even be mad. Do you practice what you preach?
Are you kidding me? I've been awake for 6 months. And have at least 50 illegitimate children being born next week.
Holy shit.
Do you have a weakness?
No. Have you seen how majestic I am?
I know what his weakness is, chat. It's the laser pointer.
I still retain my amazing hair and tight bod. I get the bitches. Both kinds.
What was your wrestling name?
Glorious Glam. The man with no plan. He wears a lot of cyan. His favorite pie is toucan.
I'm guessing the only naming prerequisites were alliteration and rhyme.
And rightly so. Is there any other way?
There's
I
not.
Don't know. What I do know is that toucan pie is delicious.
I know, right? Everyone hates it, but I adore it.
Hey man, can I borrow your necklace real quick?
What? Why?
Yeah, just to get rid of Olaf so he doesn't murder me.
Dude, he's my primary source of income. How am I supposed to afford this life of excess if you kill him? You think all this sex and drugs grows on trees? How about if I just pick some sexual favors from the local birch tree? Lick a big redwood for my Wednesday LSD trip. How about I tie a tree vine around my neck and hang from a tree while I mass... Actually, that's a pretty good idea.
Oh, no.
Anyway, no. No, you cannot.
Fuck you, dude.
Okay, so he loves JRPGs. This guy does. We learned that from the scientist. So we need to challenge him to turn-based combat.
What if I challenge you to a little bit of turn-based combat for it?
Being a huge JRPG fan, I cannot refuse.
That's lore.
I win.
I'll condition your hair every 6 hours.
You know how to tickle my little dog nipples.
What's with everyone's obsession with nipples around here?
Oh, shit!
You are probably the most stylish code leaders I know. None of this white robe bullshit.
Yeah, I know.
No! Okay. Bro! Thumbs up!
You're making me feel bad now.
Are you sure you want to hit me? I've got an enemy body pillow that really worries about me back at home.
Aww. No, dude!
I do feel kind of bad for you. Why did you even challenge me to turn-based combat in the first place?
I've got no- Oh, okay. It's time, chat.
You think you can defeat me?
Oh! Oh! Oh, shit! Go! Oh.
Dogs and lasers are funny. Turns out spending half my life procrastinating helped me out. Better go get that necklace remote thing.
Mr. A, thanks for subbing. I thought I needed this necklace, chat. Let's go talk to Grandma and see what she thinks about me just fucking up the Messiah.
Are you sure you don't want to give me some charity money?
Don't ask again. Ugh. Look at you, Reed. Maybe the...
Thank
you. I don't want to talk to you anymore. I forgot how fucking hideous you were. Okay, that's how we get into his room. How was my first JRPG? It was alright. I think it was Final Fantasy VII, chat. I was a little late. Because we didn't have any on the Nintendo or anything like that. Are those on her glasses? Those are nipples, chat. Do we go talk to, them first? Cupcake? Was there a cupcake in there? Hang on. No JRPGs on Nintendo? What I'm saying is, we didn't have it. Because I was a wee lad. Where's the fucking cupcake, dude? I have a voucher. No, I do not. What? In the office. Oh, what up, Cupcake? Oh, the PAGST. Okay. You guys are right. I forgot. I forgot that there was a legit cupcake vendor right here. Mm. Mm.
I should talk to them first.
Come on, bro. Just give me my fucking cupcake.
I would like to purchase a cupcake, please.
Sure. Do you have cash, membership, or a coupon?
Yes, actually. This PEG's membership card.
Yes. Believe in the coupon. Take your pick. My favorite is alkaline flavor.
Same.
I'll take this one.
A fine choice, sir.
See ya. I'll peruse your...
This isn't a cup...
I'm not sure, but...
Oh, hello, Paradigm Game. The guy who makes the games in chat. I broke your game, by the way. Well, kind of. Not really. I used the coin to get the tree before we found out what Olaf's weakness was. Anyway, let's go see our children, or our brothers and sisters, chat. My hide, no! I'm sober as fuck, dude! You saw? Okay.
You are the most degenerate, twisted, mentally ill people I've ever seen.
Crazy Monkey, thanks for subbing. You're currently one of the most degenerate, mentally unstable individuals I've ever seen. It's time. Let's fuck this bitch up. All pretentious artists in the world, take note.
As much as it is a big waste of a delicious cupcake, I think this screwdriver will be more handy.
Yeah. Well, there was three in there, but, you know, who's counting?
I need a small flathead screwdriver, not a Phillips. God damn it.
This would no! be a good time
to become a blacksmith. I still regret not taking that chance at the Renaissance Fair last year.
Dude! It's just like real life, chat. You go for one kind of screwdriver, you get the other one, dude. Hold on.
I'm kind of impressed that they're actually hitting the wall that hard. Nothing like risking brain damage for the sake of art.
Oh. It's time! Fuck her up!
Ah, goddamn. It was a cover for multiple screws.
No!
I know.
It really isn't. Damn it. This flat screwdriver is too big for these smaller screws. If I was a magic user, this wouldn't be a problem.
Steve Lichtman!
Gonna screw you so hard. It has rejected my advances to screw.
I don't think. Hold on.
See you.
Oh no.
So, wait.
Like, here's another thing. You probably saw me fuck with it.
You're just gonna leave, right? Okay. That would be crazy. I mean, I just told you I have a message.
What do we do?
You know, I don't have a.
The cursed plant. Do you think we can shrink the screwdriver? Really? Is it really that deep? Nice. Just leave again. Fuck Steve, dude. Let's go talk to the plant then. Hang on. Boom. Yeah, you can put keys in chat if you want, dude. I don't give a fuck, honestly. I don't. I'm not sponsored anyway. So, you do you, man. You get first person to get it gets it, dude. Boop, 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 boop.
Thank God magic does.
You're the most degenerate, twisted, mentally ill people.
It's like a baby screwdriver now.
Ginseng, thanks for subbing. I know you, man. Alright, we did it. Good job, chat.
Thank you.
You're my sponsor? Chad is my sponsor, that is true. I could fast travel? But then I don't get to listen to my Xbox 360 controller shake every time I use the elevator, chat. That is conveniently also on my crotch. That is unrelatedly stimulating me. You know? Thanks for understanding. It's time to meet your doom.
By destroying this
paradigm game,
do I become a part of the performance? Or is life just one big performance for interdimensional beings? We will never know. Unless you join a cult that claims otherwise.
Shimi is a voice actor for Paradigm 2. Do it! Yes!
Murder someone? That's a relief. I should have thought more about the consequences. I probably could have just asked nicely and got the soil that way, instead of risking manslaughter.
What do you mean, risking?
Thanks for the nutritious soil. I don't think she would be too keen to help after that incident.
The one where we killed her? Satan Doggy, thank you for the 5 months, too. And T-Bone, 2 months.
All this right. Is May I?
Take the skull? Where'd it go? Oh, it's in her head. I can't interact with it. Hang on.
I don't need the extra vitamin. I mean, look at my skin. It's glowing. Mainly because of extreme red, but also due to my health.
Hold on. What? I did take it. Okay. It's poop chat, by the way. That is actually... those are poop nuggets. Okay.
You are the most degenerate, twisted, mentally ill people I've ever seen.
Illidros, thanks for 7. Whee. It's time, chat.
I've got all the stuff to take down Olaf.
Congratulations! Alright, so the master plan is... To be honest, I was just thinking about what I was going to eat for dinner. Hang on, the advisors tell me that they actually do have a plan.
Her cat.
Alright, so all you need to do is walk in there and plant the seeds.
Mm.
The advisors actually went in there earlier and made their mark on the carpet. Mm. They say that's probably the best place.
Oh. They went in there already, why don't they just do it?
Look, something something destiny. You got to do it yourself.
Mm-hmm.
All you need to do is go to the lobby, get through the last hallway, and then you're at his lair. Then you take down Olaf. Dupa Genetics goes into liquidation, and none of this taking over the world stuff happens. Baxed with Roy Shindig, we'll all be happy. Going to be some
give
super dope cheese platters, by the way.
How good is she getting money?
Anyway, good luck, Paradigm. You're our third hope out of 4.
You mean there's more of me?
Not exactly. You're just our third plan. First plan was an internet petition. They never work. And yeah, we already had another mutated prodigy child come through here. We won't talk about that.
Oh, god damn it. Time to never finish my electronic music album and continue procrastinating. I mean, save the world from one genre of music and entertainment.
Glam metal. Ix, thank you for the 8 months. Justin, 10 months. This is Chad as my sexual partner. Ew. Vixella, thank you for the 2. Boredom, thank you for the 7, dude. You have been subbed for longer than you thought. Okay. Our current plan is to go to Olaf's office. someone should tell Reddit about the internet petition thing? Yeah. Sure should, chat. Emergency pizza bottom left here. Alright. It's time. To meet our destiny! Well, you posted a code in chat. You said the last digit or letter is missing from this. Good luck, chat. That's like 37 different potential codes, right? Okay. Open.
Good. Great. Fantastic. Couldn't have opened the regular door. Now I'll have to find some oil and lather it on my naked body to squeeze through.
Nudity is allowed. However, oil is where Duper Genetics draws the line. The punishment is remedial massage till death.
Damn you and your conservative ways. I'll have to find another way.
Okay. This isn't gonna work. It's gonna work, chat. No way. It was 8. Poetical, or poetical. It's poetical. I think he got it. 108 bits from Space Bacon says, 1 bit for every point of SR I lost tonight, rip the top 500 dream. I'm sorry, man.
Better on shrink. Then Guardi Imbecilius.
We did it. Oh, God. His shoe. Okay. I think that's the only thing we can interact with in here, so. Onwards! Trump. He does look like Trump, doesn't he?
Thank you for completing the full version of Paradigm the Game. We hope you had a great time and you had a lot of fun.
What?
If you would like to continue playing Paradigm DLC, we need more money. The Kickstarter was not enough. Please input your credit card number when the time prompts. Unlike the full version, the DLC is pay to point and click. Please purchase the 20,000 clicks now for the low price of $29.99. Otherwise, feel free to play our ad free to play version. All you need to do is press the ad viewer button
10,000
times.
Thank you very much, brother.
Oh man, I don't have a credit card on me. However, what I do know is elaborate credit card antivirus scams. All I need is a phone and a number.
What?
Hello?
You are not permitted to be here. No one is. Not even me. Well, I am actually, but I wanted to drive the point home. Anyway, leave. Otherwise, I will be forced to awkwardly linger till you leave.
Like soap.
The cream of the crop! Nobody does it better.
You can do it, Dan.
Aiden, 15 bucks.
Don't you stop, Moon.
I'm not stopping, don't worry. I have a plan, chat. Chat. I don't think I can set up a macro to click. Actually, I think I can. I just don't know how to do it. I see mouse function. I see double click. Hold on. Oh, I'm dumb. I could totally do it. Okay, let's try this. I'm not gonna lie, chat, I fucked up, and I didn't make it right, so I was hitting F7 and F8 over and over again. Okay.
Wrenches can be used to repair, but also as a low-level melee weapon.
Did I get the wrench? Move, bitch!
It's glued to the floor.
Oh my god.
I guess it's payback for all those times I glued money to the floor at shopping centers and left.
You're the most degenerate, twisted, mentally ill people I've ever seen.
Dog Hot, thanks for subbing. Quit or shut up, chat.
I've got two shoes. I'm not from Australia. Thus, no shoe beer ch- Hopefully some beer turns up. Get my chug on.
All right, we got the shoe. We need the shoe to break the emergency thing.
I cannot do an...
Okay, maybe not.
I can't do the credit card scam while they are watching me.
Typo!
That stern look is making me feel self-conscious. Well, I get mad crazy stage fright and anxiety if someone is watching me perform. Do you mind leaving me alone for a bit?
Yes, I do mind.
I need to get them to go away somehow.
I'm literally right here.
Okay.
Knife spoon is...
To kill him?
This is not a cute tiny screw. I could probably use her to solve puzzles in bulk. Ooh.
If I didn't want you to leave right now, I would say sorry.
You're the most degenerate, twisted, mentally ill people I've ever seen.
Justin Nickel, thanks for subbing.
Who are you?
I am the keeper of the Prodigy Children, originally a walking, but that time is long gone. I now have wheels, 3-inch rims, baby.
Tata, thank you for the 3.
Are you sent to water like the rest of the robots?
NTG.
Yes.
Rip
originally
wasted $15
was
that could have bought me dinner tomorrow,
gear,
but Moon just threw it away.
Hot and wet, and I was good, damn good at it. But then Dupa Genetics needed more workers. Too many work accidents, you know. Anyway, it's not too bad being the keeper. I'm a pretty chill person. Funny, considering I'm a heater. Anyway, you should leave.
No.
Why does the shower get cold when someone flushes the toilet?
My people have been searching for an answer to that question for many years, to no avail. We are yet to be able to operate internet searching systems.
Do you have a kind of sibling rivalry with the water cooler?
No, actually, we were quite good friends, but I heard that some monster drank him to death.
Uh-oh.
The same guy convinced another comrade to commit suicide.
Uh-oh.
Such a terrible world we live in.
Heh. Heh. Yeah.
Anyway, you should leave.
How do I murder you like the rest of the henchmen?
Well, you see, you just... Hey, wait a minute. What? You should leave!
Obtuse Zubat, thank you guys.
What is this place?
It's basically right. Where we grow and store all the prodigy children we have.
And greasy hair baby dick bitch, thanks for resubbing, dude.
You're the
what
most
do you
degenerate,
do
twisted, mentally ill people I've ever seen.
I tend to the broken equipment and general maintenance. I'm pretty bad at it, on account of having no arms. The main reason I'm here is to send out the shop orders. They rigged up a button I can just roll on. It's effing sweet. I'm basically a baby.
You're the most
maker.
Degenerate, twisted, mentally ill people I've ever seen.
Babies are made?
Yeah! When 100 people love each other very much, 100 being the upper limit, they mash together their DNA and pay at least $500,000 for genetic sequencing.
You're the most degenerate, twisted,
what
mentally ill people
ask
I've ever seen.
Question?
Hi, boy, Llama Mon, thank you both. Barefoot whistle, 3 months.
Did you ever want to do anything else?
Yeah, I mean, honestly, I just wanted to be a part of a family.
Aww.
I send kids to their parents almost daily through that chute. Sometimes I wish I was one of them.
Aww.
But who wants a half-ton child?
I do.
No one.
Aww. Chin up, or dials up, whatever. Though... Honestly, just follow your dreams.
Yeah. At least I still have a job to do. Okay.
How do you feel about the Dupa Genetics plan?
Lukewarm, frankly. I like neither wrestling nor glam metal. However, I heard that their education policies are some of the greatest ever made.
Laters.
Okay, don't come back now.
We need to send her through the shoot chat. Come here. And just come over here.
personally, myself, but I still haven't tried all the cereals on offer.
What?
Hello, violently sucking vent. I feel there is a more economical way to move these prodigy chat boxes. You know, other than violently sucking them up at vent.
Wrench, I can't pick it up right now.
Hello, maintenance.
She keeps dropping green stuff? It's poop! Stop pooping, that's gross. Hang on, let's get her to walk around a little more. Ew! Use it!
I could use the fumes to go on, but...
What? Hang on.
It will melt from these gloves. I need to...
I'll try looking at it.
Brings back memories of all those beautiful nights with my dear friend, Vodka.
Damn.
This is...
Huh?
The box is in the way.
Whoa! We have to wait for her to go over there and poop, right? Someone said use the shoe on the poop. Hang on. Go poop. Go poop. Hey. 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 Go poop. Go poop. Go poop.
Who thought that shoes were such great liquid holders?
Good eye, chat room.
A waste of soap. Oh man.
What?
Who thought that shoes were such great? Oh man.
Whoa! Go, dude!
It's burning away the glue. Yeah, boy!
We did it. We got the wrench. There's more poop over here. I didn't even notice that. Okay.
You're a tool for not knowing how to use a tool. Have you even heard of Tool? One of the greatest prog metal bands of the 21st century? I think not.
The slot's eyes are following me? Really?
You're a tool for not hip. Use it.
Use it for fixing or for breaking.
You're a tool hip. Use it.
There's a panel here. Let us break the panel, chat.
You're a tool hip. Use it.
Just kidding.
Oh, yeah, slidey. I am the destroyer of the gears. If only I existed in a steampunk world, I'd break shit up. Now just to turn the machine on.
Mm-hmm. Fix it, you bitch! What? Oh! Oh, Jesus!
Hope the family receiving them will mistake them for a prodigy child. They were a pretty nice person overall.
Aww.
Aww.
Let's do this morally questionable thing. I just need the phone number. I'm glad I kept that glam metal nun's number. Alright, let's do this. Scamming time! Oh god, I feel so terrible. The lesser evil.
Your call is very important to us. Please hold.
Oh god.
Hello.
Hello, Agnes. My name is Brian Smith, and I am from Crush National Antivirus, and I...
Oh, you need my credit card number. I'll give you my credit card number.
But, miss, don't you want to hear what I need it for?
Nah, that's quite all right, young man. You sound very nice. Here it is. 512331...
Remember that number, chat?
2-2-3-11. Bye.
Well, that was uncomfortably easy with a sprinkling of ethical issues. Oh, come on. This is making me feel worse.
Woo!
Not like this.
Yes!
Not like this.
Okay.
Hey, big slothead dude. My credit card is 512331512311.
Congratulations. You just purchased 400,000 clicks.
Yes!
Account balance now, minus $12 million.
No!
You'll be in debt for approximately 10,000 years.
Oh, man. I feel even worse. I guess she doesn't have much longer left.
It's true.
Especially within that messed up church.
Door unlocked.
Hey.
Probably the worst host I've ever encountered. Didn't even clean up his place.
There's candy poop on the floor. Ew.
No welcoming snacksies. I'm going to write the worst review online. People will think twice before saving the world here. Might as well go look around while I wait.
Mr. You? Hold on, chat. Forrest Gump, thank you, dude. Alright, let's see here.
I better not mess up anything just yet. Who knows what crazy shit Olaf has in store for me. Hello, vodka ingredient.
Hello, Paradigm.
What?
Hey, it's one of those potato batteries. They ban these in Krush. Using potatoes for anything other than food and vodka is a serious offense.
GLaDOS, yeah.
You really did love that Klaus guy.
Klaus, I think you are the coolest, so I made this mix CD for you. It's full of disco hits I know you love. Also a bit of glam metal. I know you're not a huge fan, but I love it. Anyway, since you're my dad, technically, want to go play some catch? Maybe something closer to your Swedish customs? Go have a meal at IKEA? Some rapping and, pillaging. Rapping and pillaging, chat. Aww. He loved his daddy, chat. What a pussy, dude. Honestly, man.
Oh, nice. It's a head sculpture of Mr. You. In 2021, they tried to reboot the A-Team again. The real Mr. T cost too much, so they just cloned him.
Mm-hmm.
Hello, Mr. You head sculpture. I salute you, Mr. You. I definitely want to steal this once this is all over.
Oh, God.
What the hell?
It's me. Oh, God.
I think this is Klaus. Not going to lie, that stash alone makes me wish I could meet him. The whole making me thing is secondary. Hello, oil painting of my biological father. I think this would look pretty good at my crib. Would probably creep out any girls who come over. Good thing they never do come over. I'm going to have a field day on Ibeski once this is all over. I'm not sure I want to.
Oh, come on.
Hello, weird family photo.
Battery, I see it, chat. Yeah, just walk all the way around, you fucking bitch.
Part of me really wants to put my tongue on it.
Mm-hmm.
It took me 3 weeks to stop licking a 9-volt battery last time. I better not.
Has anyone ever actually done that, chat?
Hello, big battery.
Hello.
I better not mess up anything just yet.
Okay.
Who knows what crazy shit Olaf has in store for me? I've got to use it and take the cover.
You have? I've never licked a battery before, chat. It's fun. As a child, you did it? Bro. Oh, this is where we're supposed to put the tree.
I can't plant. I need to make sure Olaf isn't here. If he hears that there is a tree in here, he might not come in.
So is he gonna let me do it in front of his face? Come on, bro. It's like you've never killed a candy-vomiting sloth before.
I never knew Kupu's Mechunder. For those days, you just don't want to vomit. Keep one in the cupboard handy. This one's a bit beat up, though. Hello, can full of Chunder.
It's such an unpleasant feeling, really?
I need to open it up first. I used to carry on the can opener in my pocket religiously.
Oh.
Until the accident. Those 2 months of recovery took a lot of self-control.
Well, I have something that could open up cans, chat.
I better not make.
Alright, okay. Mouse generator.
Oh, jeez. That mouse is super jacked.
Do you need any lifting tips, brah?
Hello, totally jacked mouse. That mouse looks like it's ready to wreck shit up. Look at those biceps. Pretty sure he is not keen. Pretty sure that mouse can beat the shit out of me. No picking up from me.
Oh no. Alright. Guess we go to the monitors, chat.
I think this is what the telepathic cats meant when they said they left a mark. I guess that's what happens when you don't have any opposable thumbs. At least it is good for the soil. Hello, unnecessary cat markings.
Those are totally necessary.
I probably should make sure before I...
Okay.
It's a security camera terminal of... Holy shit. I'm weirded out.
And that is why you should respect humans and not brutally murder them. Even in light of injustices they have brought upon our people.
Isn't he dead? Okay. Was this in the past? No. That's cocaine, chat.
They've got cameras everywhere.
Doc, just look at it, Rochelle 3103023. Defrag.
I've never felt so turned on before! Most of the time, I'm on power save. It's great, but so inefficient. I'm so conflicted as a server!
Oh, John 3000. Getting it in as per usual.
John turned my home into a robot brothel.
It's a...
God damn it. Also, a more pressing matter. Why are there cameras everywhere? Oh, God, how long have they been there? I have to find the tapes and burn them. Mankind should not be subject to my shameful personal rituals.
Oh God, it's him.
Oh, hey man, heard you want to murder me. What's up with that?
You're looking perplexed, Paradigm. Many questions must be running through your mind.
This might be inappropriate, but I was wondering if I could get some sloth cuddles. I've been thinking about it since I first heard of you.
What? I'm not a huge cuddle guy. Also, what the hell? I would never cuddle with you.
Damn it.
Does your wig have a name?
Yes, it's called Kill Yourself.
Oh, shit! Olaf!
Why are there cameras everywhere in Krush? If my life is a reality TV show, I hope to be paid handsomely.
No, no. Krush is not a reality television show. Although, in hindsight, I feel kinda dumb for not doing that. If I didn't need to dissect you, I'd probably put you on the creative team for Duper Genetics. Anyway, Krush was a town created to observe and research failed prodigy children. Space Cadet, the Drug Dealer, the Cone, they are all horrible, magnificent failures of the prodigy child program.
Oh God.
But you, Paradigm, you were special. You were not a reject. In fact, you were the end game of the prodigy child program. Class's golden child. The world's salvation. Don't you see I'm monologuing here? I've been writing this for days. I even had everyone from the facility proofread it. I put a lot of work into it. Please, listen. Anyway, money and power never mattered to Klaas. He wanted to make the world a better place. He wanted to create the perfect human. The perfect human being to lead us to a utopian society. That is why he made you, Paradigm.
Mm-hmm.
He truly believed mankind's greatest trait was empathy, and that the perfect human being needed to experience dire circumstances to evolve into that. There is only so much genetic programming can do to shape one's soul.
Lame.
As you can gather, this is why you are truly hideous, Paradigm. Shocking. Terrifying. Vomit-inducing. Makes me want to dig out my eyeballs, douse my head in acid. If you had a mother, she would probably sell you for a pack of ciggies.
Oh no. Hold on, chat. Scratchy Cow, RuneScape, you think you can just come to my chat room and beg for Twitch Prime RuneScape garbage? Fuck no! Get out! Never come back! If you are talking to people in my chat room about free shit that you can't afford, go get a job! Buy Twitch Prime and then sub to me! Fuck off!
Broad Punch, thanks for subbing.
No, you are.
You're the most degenerate, twisted, mentally ill people I've ever seen.
He nearly drove the company into the ground, constructing you. What about me? What about poor old Olaf? I exist solely to vomit out candy bars. What kind of life is this? I loved Klaas more than you ever could have. When he died, I knew it wasn't from diabetes following his severe candy addiction. It was the stress from making you. After he went, I had nothing left.
I was not expecting that. Notorious, thank you for subbing.
Carried on my father's dream of the perfect world. I tried to remove you from all of this. I tried to kill you. But I just couldn't. And now, ironically, you will fulfill his ultimate plan. Eventually achieving Klaas's dream.
Have you got much longer to go? Can I find the speech online so I can take notes later?
I swear to God, Paradigm, if you try to interrupt me again,
Oh god. I'm gonna die if I do that, chat, right? Let's do it!
Wanna hear about my beatboxing eggplant?
Enough! I guess that threat was pretty empty. I still want to finish my monologue before I kill you. Because Father adored you so much, I continued observing you for many years. I tried to figure out why Klaas thought you would be so great. Maybe even try and be more like you. Your existence disgusted me. But in spite of everything, there was one thing I wanted to take away from you. Even after your death, I will become the greatest electronic musician the world has ever seen. Not you. And in honor of Klaas, I will kill you to the sweet sound of disco synth and lasers. Time to do the murder boogie.
Oh god!
Wait, hold up. Before you kill me, can I ask some questions? Did you, see me do that thing I do alone when I think no one is watching?
Yes. I didn't even know that was possible, or that people can even stoop that low. I was sick for weeks.
Don't knock it till you try it.
Benster submits says, what on earth did I join into? The climax.
What's up with the whole glam metal and wrestling thing?
The thing is, Klaas didn't even like glam metal. I tried to get him to listen multiple times, but he never took to it. Always talking about electronic disco music. God damn disco! Anyway, I needed to pick a genre to control the masses. And I didn't know anything else.
I was hoping there would be a deeper meaning to it than that. How about glam metal represents the hyperbole and excess in our modern lives? A way to look at ourselves and see from another perspective.
You're the most degenerate, twisted, mentally ill people I've ever seen. Race.
See, not that hard to strain a narrative out of your actions.
Zendoria, thanks for subbing again.
Why are you constantly vomiting out candy?
Father only made me for one purpose. To be a living candy machine. The only reason he imbued the candy-making gene in me was because I was what was left lying around after some laboratory tests. Hence the reason he constantly calls me trash.
Oh, no, dude.
Are you sure
the
you
cream of the crop
kill me?
Nobody does it better.
Probably loved you.
Wow, man. It's not possible to get a GF on RS if you're not member.
No.
Frown.
He told me multiple times that I was trash to him. He even made me sit and watch a 3-hour PowerPoint presentation about why I'm worthless and I'm only good for making candy.
Why didn't you stop me earlier?
To be honest, I started binge-watching a TV show. Suddenly, it was 3 seasons later. I mean, I had so much to do, but it was so good.
Yeah, true. I can relate. What was it?
Man-eating mutant finds multiple wives for eternal servitude. He just ends up eating them. I feel bad for him.
It feels bad, man. All right.
Enough. Let's get this over with.
By the way, Paradigm, you acquired
243
shit guy points, and thus triggered the evil ending.
No!
To rectify this, you must scour all night long through fan-made wikis and read up on the most obscure forums to get every single ending possible.
Oh, you fucker.
Just messing with you. Life is just a linear experience in which you are in no control of any of your actions.
Oh, no.
No free choice.
Bro!
Just an endless, infinite cycle in which you are doomed to repeat all your mistakes.
Oh, my God!
Anyway, here is a bunch of endings you can choose.
Mass Effect 3 PogChamp? We gotta go for the actual ending, chat. Leopard print, that's the glam metal ending, chat. I'm gonna do the actual ending, chat. Save scum? Alright, that's a good idea, actually. Well played. Let's start with the actual ending.
Alright, Paradigm. It's time to say goodbye. Time to say goodbye with the sweet tunes of synth disco. May it haunt you in the afterlife. Engage disco lasers!
Pause, time. And with that, I saw my life flash before my eyes.
Sorry, the number you have dialed is not in service at this time.
And pause time.
I forgot about the anti-assassination force field. Turns out it works both ways. Hey, Paradigm, do you mind walking a little closer?
No.
You're going to die, Paradigm.
What have I done?
Ghost class will
no!
Ugh, I need to move faster.
Okay.
I really wish I could do a Rocky-style montage. Not that it's convenient right now. There must be a better way to be faster.
Boys, will ye boys? Stand a little closer.
It has to be like a little closer. It can't be any other reference. Wait, I remember in that children's book, full of vomited candy. Gross.
Hey, I've been saving that for reanimated class. I have 5 Baba Yagas working around the clock to bring him back from the dead. So far, they've spent my advance on vodka and mushrooms. I still believe, though.
Mudcake, thank you for the 7. Sorry, I missed you. So, we got it.
All those cups of coffee at home really have cranked up my caffeine tolerance. I should eat more of these.
What?
A bit peppier, could still go for another. Ooh, I could finish at least, could still go.
Bro!
I think that is enough candy. I don't want to become a diabetic too.
Okay. Wise.
My heart sure feels like death right now. I'm pushing the human body to the limit for the good of mankind. Could still go for another. I think I can see through time. Oh God, what is happening?
Jesus Christ, what's going on?
Holy shit!
Shut up, people. That mess looks like home. Potato science is the work of the devil. I carve heavy devil.
Damn it, Paradigm. Powering the laser was all that Potato had. What is he going to tell his potato family? Please, just plug it back in so I can kill you.
Yeah, nah.
Okay.
Oh, God.
What? I've been roused.
Oh, God. That mouse will be purple.
Kill him.
Nice.
Okay. What else we got? Here we go.
I think I don't.
We're gonna get jacked and fuck him up, chat.
I feel jacked. I better go to him. I feel jacked. That metal purple. Pretty snowball.
Oh, come on. Oh, there's a cheesy bar.
But I hope that you guys can be real assholes when it comes
on. Oh, cool, dude.
Nope. He does not like. Oh, God.
Oh, it's giving the protein bar. Okay.
Here is some more view.
Cheers, dude. My body is now ready to experience a new level of body dysmorphia.
Damn it, Chad. Keep pedaling.
Chad.
I need the power for the laser to kill Paradigm.
Sorry, bro. My thighs are too jacked.
Oh, yes. Lasers are offline. Those energy bars are wearing off too. Time to do the pigs plan.
Mm-hmm.
Now, where was their mark again?
Oh, man! Really? I don't really have a plan B here.
Time to kill you, man. Sorry.
You were so good at solving puzzles. I certainly didn't. From the security cam vision, I'm actually shocked you managed to survive this whole time. Ever since we dumped you there.
Almost time to stop this procrastination journey.
Hey, hang on a second. What is that dirt for?
No biggie. I just like placing it. You know, I'm just a quirky guy.
You're lying! That's it, Paradigm. I'm going to crush you with my chair. Prepare for pain.
Come on, man. Don't be like this.
I'm gonna get ya.
No, please. Bro.
I really would like to cuddle you, but, you know, when you don't want to kill me.
Well, I'm all out of ideas. Would you consider just killing yourself?
Yeah.
It would make things a lot easier. It would mean a lot.
It's tempting. However, I regret to inform you, I respectfully decline.
Shit. All right. Well, I'm just going to go online and post on forums to see what the next step is. Come back tomorrow, and I should have something ready for you.
Okay.
Hello, fellow internet friends. I am looking to kill someone ASAP. What do you think is the best way? Can anyone give me a tutorial over Skype? Signed, Pusslayer 25123. Go kill yourself.
Holy shit, it's time.
Man, I really hope this works.
Did you just plant an instant tree? Oh, God. Why did I stock that in the vending machine?
I better stand back. Oh, good.
Nice. God bless Duper's guaranteed 80% product failure rate.
No.
Maybe I'll just hire a hitman from the deep web. How does that sound, Paradigm?
Wait, something is happening.
Uh-oh.
Oh, don't vomit, dude.
This tree is so beautiful. I love trees.
OS Sloth in chat, please.
Good job, Paradigm.
Thanks. Wait. What the hell? How did you get through there?
What? Oh, turns out there is another entrance.
I'm pretty mad right now. I can't even emote.
Psh. Well, you saved the world from an entertainment dictatorship. What are you going to do now?
Probably should finish my EP. I think I brought the sport of procrastination to its peak, to be honest. I'm basically the procrastination king.
May your reign last for thousands of years.
Going to lie, after that whole pretending I'm dead thing, I didn't think Paradigm would buy me a car. I have to go think that OG. Especially so next time I can't pay rent, he'll be always mad. I should go ask John where he's at.
Oh, it's his lady friend, chat. Look at her nip-nips.
Hey, John. Have you seen Paradigm? How's the whole creepy toe-chasing robot thing going for you?
Funny you say that. Tom's a changed duck. Got my little missus here. I've fallen in love. I never knew the love a washing machine could give. She keeps me clean. Figuratively and literally.
Oh, right. Big ups to you, big man. Where can I find him?
Oh, yeah? Old mate is heading out on tour.
Oh, bro. Why didn't he invite me?
He did. Multiple times. You just kept beatboxing over him and pretended not to hear since you thought he was asking for rent.
Oh, right. Where is he going exactly?
He should still be at the buzzer stop down at the edge of town. Do you need directory days?
Man. I can never understand the thing you're saying.
Do you need help getting there?
Yes, actually.
You gonna head there now?
Hang on, I'm going to look around.
Xenix, think you're the three.
No worries, mate.
Where did Paradigm get all this new gear from? Does he have a new beatboxing eggplant that actually pays rent? There'll be no more dropping of fat beats if that's the case.
Yeah. Oh, it's his bed.
Paradigm continues to think of new ways to make himself as unsexy as possible. I'm impressed. Whoa. Looks like Paradigm is actually doing some work. Or just procrastinating again by eating ungodly amounts of cereal.
Titan Master, thank you for the 4 months, dude. This is Lady Nipnops. What else? I think that's it. I believe that is it. There we go. Oh, yeah, dude.
Hey, John. What are those directions?
Just take a mizzer and walk down Old Borkvitz Road. Make a sharp bloody left on Dinky Derovitz Road. Then go Dinky left on Old Raza Road. Go through Kush Forest. Then continue through to Wolf Wolf Tunnel.
Mm-hmm.
The refreshing breeze of nuclear fallout.
Let's ride.
You may not.
No, it's a troll goblin bridge. Traveler. Bridge
you must
troll.
Answer these riddles too. Or was it three? I'm not sure. Let's just make it three for now.
I have already passed the bridge.
Oh, damn it, really?
Yeah, sorry, Shannon. You're getting better at this every day. Watch a few more video tutorials and you'll be a real bridge troll.
Ah, thanks for understanding, Doug.
Aww. Oh, it's the bird that fell earlier in the game. No, no, exit!
This is Republic of Pashinska's pride and joy, Luda Nava. First car in Eastern Europe to hear the tape deck. I lost my heap of virginity in there.
Mm-hmm.
Worst, there's always Vodka and Siggy's on these devils. Yogiski Bear is behind this. He has more substance addiction than the average bear.
Aww. $420. Yeah, that's that good shit.
It's really nice to see that Paradigm is spending his money wisely. Graffiti murals are doing great in this economy.
Hmm.
I remember hearing about this accident. Bunch of rats managed to ride this in tandem. Apparently they were brilliant drivers. It's everyone else that is terrible at merging.
Rip. Was a penis? No. Oh, there is a penis. Oh god.
How about this?
I think a little more beep boop.
They're friends now, chat. Actually. Aww.
Well, well, well. Look who it is. My favorite unnutritious vegetable.
Haven't you heard? Eggplants are now considered a part of the gangster family. None of these vegetables are actually fruit bullshit.
If I wasn't so excited about this new track me and Olaf wrote, I would berate you about how stupid that is.
I feel pretty left out, man. Not going to lie.
Don't worry. You're going to be beatboxing in the interlude.
Yeah, boy. Also, sorry about that whole beatbox ignoring thing.
Oh, good man. You're my boy.
Damn it, bro. I'm gonna cry.
Aww.
Let's hear that new track.
Paradigm game.
It's so loud. We did it.
We actually team up and do this glam metal and wrestling thing together. Like brothers.
Well, I was looking forward to killing you. I guess that is the more practical idea. Sure, let's team up.
We interrupt your viewing of How to Live Faster and Die Younger with Glam Metal with your compulsory hourly viewing of Do You Really Know? Supreme Glam Leader Paradigm. If not, please make your way to the Glamification Center for Light Torture. Supreme Glam Leader Paradigm dedicated his life of extreme excess to the Church of Latter-day Glam in 2026, in which he immediately became the glorious Supreme Glam Leader. His famous physique you see today is the product of his very own vodka immersion therapy, available to rent now at all good health club stores.
Wow!
Wow!
Cool to know. Upon his appointment of Supreme Glam Leader, he immediately romanced all the world's leaders and gained autonomous reign of the whole world and its people. He then, in all his glorious wisdom, swiftly went to work to bring enormous positive change to humanity. Glam metal and wrestling became the only form of entertainment through Medium Force. He reimagined the food pyramid for the modern devotee of excess. Cash incentives for extramarital sex. Let us not forget Supreme Glam Leader's spending on drugs and escorts alone contribute to half the world's economy.
Wow!
He is so glorious. Now remember, to live the life of excess is to live like Supreme Leader Paradigm. If you disagree, please make your way to Glamification Center for some light torture.
Oh, you get to just... Okay.
Hello, this is Dark Mutant Lover 31, and this is my original story for what I think how Paradigm should end. Please don't steal. It's copyrighted, okay? Don't mess with me. Seriously. I'm gonna start now. Paradigm burst into the room with a face of pure anger. In the back of the room, a lone hovering chair appeared with its back facing him. He knew it was Olaf. Paradigm was prepared for ultimate battle and reached over to touch Olaf's shoulder. You are the worst, Olaf! Prepare to die! Paradigm kicked over a chair to show he meant business. But crying was the only reply he could hear. What is wrong, Olaf? Why are you crying? I'm sorry, Paradigm, Olaf said with tears rolling down into his hairy sloth chest. He then span his chair around. Paradigm, I know this might not be the right time, but I like you. I like you. Paradigm stood there astonished, and he felt a warm sensation tingle in his tumor.
Mm-hmm.
He never felt before. I didn't know you felt that way. Why did you try to kill me? I'm just awkward like that. I'm misunderstood nice guy. I have trouble showing my emoticons, but if you get to know me, you will find out how smart and funny I am. Really. But you must know, I can't hold it any longer. I'm pregnant with Doug's son,
no.
Olaf admitted. Doug burst through the door. You betrayed me, Doug. I thought you did not have reproductive organs. There is a lot about me you don't know, Paradigm. Doug then started to morph into his true form. Paradigm then began to have more confusing feelings for Doug he never thought of before. Doug, I think I actually love you, Paradigm said without realizing. Doug, Olaf, and Paradigm, then...
Please stop it. Please stop it.
There you have it. I was inches away from death. I didn't know it at the time, but everything was going to turn out all right in the end. Me and Olaf would put our differences aside, and we would become good friends.
Aww.
I found the love of my life in Ivanka, and Doug was my best man at the wedding. Life was really starting to pan out, and to my surprise, I developed a North American accent. Funny how life works like that sometimes. However, just by figuring out how to speak to you in the past, I inevitably doomed this timeline to total destruction. I already feel the laws of physics changing and my eyeballs being pulled out. Neat.
I can't turn it down, chat.
Thank you.
Actually scared me a little bit, chat.
Alright, we're good, boys.